Hi, I'm Will with Kimray, where we help energy producers solve their biggest control challenges. Today I'm going to show you how to convert a back pressure regulator from vent to non-vent. When a back pressure regulator is operating correctly, it vents pressure off the diaphragm as it adjusts. However, some producers need to convert the regulator from venting to non-venting. You may need to do this if you're using the regulator inside a building, facing increased emissions regulations, or for safety concerns. These are the parts you'll need. To make this process as simple as possible, we offer all-in-one conversion kits that include the tubing, connector, T, and elbow. Check this chart for the kit part number you'll need for your size valve. If you're using a vise, mount it slightly off-center so that when it comes time to install the new elbow, you'll be able to attach it without adjusting the valve. First, unthread the adjustment bolt to relieve the spring pressure. Then loosen the tubing. Remove the bonnet bolts but leave them in place to keep the assembly from coming apart. Remove the tubing from the body and inspect the diaphragm for damage. If it's damaged, it will need to be replaced. Remove the upper pilot seat with a 9/16 wrench. Keep the upper seat assembly together as you separate it from the upper diaphragm plate. Remove and discard the current spring and replace it with the new stronger spring from the conversion kit. Because we are venting to downstream, it can take a little more force to keep the pilot plug seated in some situations. With the new spring in place, put the upper seat assembly back on the upper diaphragm plate and tighten. If this has been done correctly, you'll feel the resistance of the spring as you push the pilot plug down. Rotate the tubing 90 degrees so that you can prop the pilot housing assembly upright and not damage the pilot plug. Loosen the bolts on the upper housing and set it aside. Inspect this diaphragm for any damage and replace it if needed. Inspect the lower housing's gasket for damage, but don't tip it over because it has oil in it. Apply new grease to the gasket. Rotate the lower housing so that the vent plug is 90 degrees from both inlets. Rotate the upper housing vent plug to the downstream side. Verify that the lower diaphragm is positioned correctly. Hand start the bolts through the upper housing into the body and tighten in a crisscross pattern. Install the pilot housing assembly back onto the upper housing, making sure that the diaphragm is not pinched or off-center. Insert the tubing into the elbow on the body, but do not tighten it yet. Tighten each bonnet bolt gradually so that the pressure on the diaphragm is applied evenly. Now tighten the tubing connectors. Remove the vent plugs from the upper and lower housings. Make sure that the ferrules on both ends of the new connector are still installed. Apply primer and Loctite to the T-threads and install it into the lower housing. Next, apply primer and Loctite to the connector and install it. Remove the plug on the downstream side of the body and apply primer and Loctite to the elbow. Install it so that the tubing connection is facing the upstream outlet. Now we'll be installing the tubing. After bending and cutting your tubing, be sure to pre-install the ferrules by tightening the nut to the connector with the tube firmly inserted. Then remove the tubing to inspect the ferrule has attached correctly. Now you can install the tubing. Lastly, tighten your adjustment bolt on top for your desired set point. Now your regulator is non-venting.
To order a non-vent conversion kit or speak to an expert about this process, contact your local Kimray store or authorized distributor today.